What's up, peeps? This is Goldface Akuza. First off, I would like to thank you guys so much for all the love and support and for the 15,000 subscribers. Honestly, I wouldn't make it this far without all the support from you guys. So I owe you a big one. And a big welcome to all of you who are new to my channel. And as a thank you gift for all the love and support, I'm launching a new Photoshop tutorial series. Actually, not one, but two Photoshop tutorial series. Number one, about the basics of Photoshop, some of the basic tips, tricks, and techniques of Photoshop for the beginners. And number two, some of the coolest effects that you can achieve with the help of Photoshop, and some of the most important applications of Photoshop in the graphic design industry. So subscribe and stay tuned, because it's time for you to become a pro in Photoshop. Now in this tutorial, I'm going to teach you four different ways of coloring in Photoshop. Now, these are not strictly by the books, these are some contemporary methods that I've picked up and discovered over the years as I gain experience. This is my journey from being a beginner to becoming a professional and how I evolved with time and experience. So let's begin with technique number one, which is basically the traditional manual coloring technique. Now let's say we have an enclosed line art on a blank layer, and we want to color the area enclosed by the line art. So what we'll do is we'll take a new blank layer underneath the line art layer right here, the bottom of the layer tab, and it brings a new layer. Now we'll go to the toolbar and select the brush tool from here, and we'll select the color. Select any color of our choice, and we'll go to the blank layer and manually color it like that. It takes time, but you'll eventually get there. Now the disadvantage of this step is that it's pretty time consuming, and it needs a lot of patience, and it's not professional at all. So we'll skip this step and move on to step number two, which is selection and coloring. So this time we'll go to the toolbar and select the lasso tool. This is the lasso tool. So we'll again take a new layer underneath the line art layer, and we'll select the area enclosed by it, just like painting, like this. If you go tired of selecting, just let it go and it'll save the selection area, and just continue again with a new patch, like that. And if by chance you end up selecting some area outside of the box, you can just undo it or simply just continue doing what you're doing. And once you're done with that, you can go and select the inverse selection tool from up here and select the areas that have escaped the enclosed area. And what it does, it automatically deselects these areas. So once that's done, we're gonna color this area. We can do this by using, again, the manual technique, doing this fast. But do I recommend it? No, this is not professional at all. We're gonna use the paint bucket tool by going to the gradients option that's just below the eraser, right click, and we have the paint bucket tool. You just click on the enclosed layer and it'll just color it automatically. But there's an even faster way of doing this, which is with the help of the keyboard shortcut Alt Backspace. And what Alt Backspace does is it fills the area with the color of the foreground color. Now what is foreground color? If you come to the bottom of the toolbar, you'll see these two layers. The top layer is called foreground color. You can use it with the help of the shortcut Alt Backspace. And the layer beneath it is called the background layer, the background color. You can use it with the help of the keyboard shortcut Control Backspace. So now that you know it and you know the technique, let's talk about the disadvantages. The drawbacks of this step is that it's time consuming, it takes a lot of patience, and again, this is not the most professional way of doing it. So let's move on to step number three, which is again a selection and coloring process, but this time with the help of magic selection tool. So again, we'll take a new layer just underneath the line art layer, and this time we'll go to the toolbar and select magic selection tool from here, magic selection tool. Now we'll go to the line art layer and click once on the enclosed area, and what it does is it selects the entire area enclosed. So we'll come back to the blank layer underneath it, and we'll use the shortcut option, that shortcut key that we just learned in the previous step, or backspace. What it does is it colors the whole area. Now, this is the easiest, the quickest step, but at the same time it is also the laziest step. It doesn't give you the best results, so I do not recommend it for professional work. Now, the thing is that it looks okay from a distance, but when you zoom in, it doesn't look that good after all, right? You see that that white border, thin border that hasn't colored yet? Well, that's the reason why this is not the best step. The reason is that Photoshop does not support vector graphics. It only supports raster graphics, which means the edges are never completely sharp and smooth. There's always this blurry, jittery effect. So that's the main drawback of this effect, of this step. So to counter this, we have step number four, the final step, which is the most professional way according to me. This is fast, this is easy, this is quick, and this again gives you the best result. So we'll go to the line art layer, and just like the previous step, we'll use the magic selection tool to fill, to select the area by one click. There, selected. Now we'll again take a new layer just underneath the line art layer, and go fill it with a color with the help of the shortcut alt backspace. It's colored. Now we just want to take care of this blank border that hasn't been colored yet. So what we'll do now is go to the FX option from right below, from the bottom of the layer tab, and select stroke. What stroke does is it draws a border around the colored part in the layer. We'll select the color, we'll match it with the color of the enclosed area there, and next we'll adjust the size, the thickness of the border, and usually 3 or 4 does the job, 3 or 4 pixels there. That's it. Now it's completely done. If you zoom in, you'll see that the blank white layer that hadn't been color is completely filled with color now. There's no leakage or blank space. See, that was quick, and this step is a bit technical, but once you know it, once you master it, you own it. Now if you want to have a clean layer, just right click on that layer and select rasterize layer style. What it does, it flattens the layer. So there you have it, the fourth step, my key trick that I want to teach you to get the most professional and quickest result in no time. So that's it for now. Hope you learned something new from this tutorial, and if you found this useful, go ahead and subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for the upcoming tutorials. Do not miss them.